Hello and welcome to Good Rig Tutorials. This is where I'll show you how I make my textures, how I do my backgrounds, how I do pretty much anything CG related. So if you're into CG, computer graphics of any sorts, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how I make my bump textures for my aircraft models. For that purpose, we'll be looking at Adobe Illustrator. We'll be looking at Photoshop, and lastly, in this case, Modo, but it could be pretty much any 3D application out there. And this is the result we're aiming for today. This is my model of the F-102, the Deuce, and if we zoom in a little bit, you can see that we got some panel lines, we got some rivets, and between the rivets in those little frames here, the fuselage is ever so slightly bent, but not every, let's call it a frame in here, is bent equally. So this is the result we're aiming for, and how I'm gonna do. Well, I'm gonna show you how I do it. There's probably many ways, and I would be very interested in knowing how you do it. So let's dive into it. First off, Illustrator. Here we are in Illustrator, and this is the exact bump map you saw being used on the F-102. This one consists of two different elements. Usually I would have a few more different rivet sizes, but on this one I only have one rivet size, so it's pretty easy to get a grasp of what it is all about, this one. The panel lines here, simple straight or curved lines using the pen tool or the basic shape tools. And it's just a matter of drawing every panel line out. And once that is done, add a medium gray background to it, and then you have the panel line layer. So that's the first bump map layer I will use on my aircraft models. The second bump map layer is where it really comes to life, and that is where I add my rivets. And as you can see here, my rivets, I've marked them with a red edge color, and if we zoom in, you can easily see it's a line of circles. There is a pretty clever trick to do that in Illustrator, and I'm sure some of you are familiar with it, but I'm going to show you how it's done anyway. Here we use the pen tool and we make a line. Just for the sake of illustration here, I'll bump that up to, let's say, 10 points. Inside the stroke dialog, I'll add the rounded endings and make it a dashed line. When I have my dashed line engaged, I will make the dashes 0 points in length, and I will choose what gap size between the dashes I'll choose for this project. Now, it's 5, it's a little bit small for a 10-point line, so let's try to make it 30. And here we are. Here we have the line of rivets, and if we want a larger gap, we can simply increase the gap between the dashes in here. And it's as easy as that. Usually I would make around 2 or 3 different size rivets for my models, but on this one there's only one. Had I used a different size rivets than the ones I already have here, I would mark them in a different color, because once I have all the rivets done, I can select one of the rivet lines, go and choose select, same stroke color, and now I have all of the rivets marked on my model. And that's very useful for getting the rivets imported into Photoshop, which is what I'm going to show you next. Here in Photoshop, I've imported my panel lines layer. And, well, this is pretty much what I would use from the first bump map layer. Just the panel lines and the gray background. For the second bump map layer, I will need my rivets too. So I go into Illustrator, select all of my rivets, copy, and paste them into my document. So here we have two separate layers, panel lines and rivets. Had I had more layers of rivets, different size rivets, I would import those into a different layer too. But as we only have one size rivets here, I'm going to stick with this. And now it's a matter of getting started. Before I get started with adding the stressed skin between the panel lines, between the rivet lines, I'll make sure that my document is in 16-bit. So here we can start making the second bump map. And what I choose to do is I select my rivets and in a new layer, get all of the rivets to be black. I copy that. So I have two black rivet layers. The bottom rivet layer, I'll go to Gaussian blur and blur that quite a bit. The top rivet layer, I'll go to Gaussian blur again and blur it, but not quite as much. So for this one, we need to adjust the opacity a bit. So now we have two black areas around the rivets. What I can't do here is merge the two layers, Control E, and go into Gaussian blur again and blur that layer out a little bit so it all sort of flows together nicely. So here we have a dark area around the rivets, and now I will, depending on what model I'm working on, choose a medium gray after I've selected my rivet layer, and in a new layer, added the medium gray to the, here we go. So I got medium gray rivets and a dark area between them. This result here would make the rivets pop out of the fuselage. It's not always what you want, but for this one, we probably wouldn't like the rivets to pop quite as much out as this suggests. So we can adjust the opacity here. It usually takes a little bit of going back and forth between the, oh, now I got rivets in both my layers. That was not what I wanted. So let's just do that once more. Here we are. So if I want to make the rivets a little less visible on the end result, I can adjust the opacity something like this. If I want them to really pop out, I can increase the opacity and maybe even make the layer brighter. Now, so far so good. Now we got the rivets done, and what I want to do now is I will make a sort of depression around the panel lines too. So I copy my panel line layer again, Gaussian blur, and get a decent sized blur out of that. I can do that again if I want the effect to be a little bit more visible. Go again, Gaussian blur, but not quite as much. And then we get a sort of deeper depression around the panel lines. I can adjust the opacity a bit and remove it. So here we have the panel line depressions. So if this was the result, we would have the panel lines, some sort of the fuselage panels to bend in where the near the edges of the panels, and to sort of make this wavy effect over the rivets. And that's pretty much what we're aiming for. If we use this one as it is right now, the depressions and the rivets would really be deep and pop really much out, but for the sake of illustration, I think this is okay. Now, the last bit is to make this sort of stressed skin between the panel lines and between the rivet lines. And what I do here is I'll go to a new layer and make it black and white. Go to clouds. And I got the cloud layer. So something like this. It's a completely random pattern of black and white areas. This is what makes the stressed skin effect. So this is what we want to hold on to, but we don't want the wavy panels to be near the rivets or the panel lines. So I go to my rivet layer and select it, and go to modify in select, and go to expand. And for this one, I would probably expand it to, let's say, 6 pixels. Then I go and make it sort of fade out toward the edges. Choose like 5 here. And now I got selected the areas near the rivets. And we don't want that to be wavy, so we'll have to remove that part. So there we are. We do the exact same thing for the panel lines and expand. This one we'll probably want to expand a bit more and fade out, sort of something like 10 points. So now we got the areas around the rivets to be medium gray and the areas around the panel lines also to be medium gray and the areas in between to be unaffected. So that's the cloud layer. This one would make the, if we continued with this result, we'll get some very wavy skin, some. So a bit of Gaussian blur again would work wonders. And how much we wanna make it, how much we wanna blur it, well, it's up to taste and what aircraft you're working on, but something like this might work. And I usually make it take screen as blend mode. Reduce the opacity a bit, and actually we can sort of tell that some areas are very bright, so they will pop out quite much, and other areas are not quite as bright, so they won't pop out as much. And this is really what gives us the wavy effect, the stressed skin effect. So let's look at the result in Modo. Now, back in Modo, here we have the two bump maps I use. This one is the line map, the panel lines, which is pretty straightforward. It's just black lines on a gray background. But and this one is the map we just made in Photoshop. So what we see here is the rivets that pop just a little bit out of the fuselage, and we see the differences in the bumpiness of each of these rivet frames we got here. And overall, you can see the aircraft on at a distance, it doesn't make that much of a difference, but once you get into the close-ups or the high-resolution renders, that really is what makes the aircraft the aircraft stand out. So this is the result, and once combined with the rest of the maps, it can look pretty good. Here we are. And if I really wanted this to pop, I would likely crank up the reflection a little bit here. And then we can probably see it somewhere that there is a slight difference in the and the bumpiness of the surface. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you like what you see, and give this video a thumbs up. And also in the comment section, let me know if there's anything I do that you wanted to know how I do, or if you do something a lot more clever than I do, I too would be very interested in knowing what it is. Thank you, and see you next time.